Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. I hope that all of you are fine and doing very good in this period of quarantine. I cordially welcome all my dear students back to the school. You are having your new books, your new notes, your new folders, and your new pouches. Each and everything is new. And one more thing, the situation is also new. You are sitting in a virtual classroom. The virtual classroom is there because COVID has taken over everything. Now, when you are sitting for a virtual class, the first thing, you must pay full attention and you should listen with focus so that the things will become more clear to you. Now, the subject of science has further divided into subcategories, and I am going to teach you one of those categories, and that is physics. Dear 8th class, welcome to the first lecture of physics. Nature is inspiring. The human beings are affected by the different natural phenomena which are happening around them. This has caused the human beings to think about different natural phenomena. The question of why, how, and when continuously arises in the mind of every thinker. And the answers of these questions became the base of the branch of knowledge which is known as the natural philosophy. Natural philosophy was renamed after 19th century as science, which I have already read in the previous classes. Science was further subdivided into two subcategories. The first one is the biological sciences. Biological sciences is the study of all the living things like the humans, animals, plants, etc. The second category is of physical sciences. Physical sciences is the study of all the non-living things. Physical sciences are further subdivided into 5 subcategories. One of them is geology. Geo means earth. In this branch, they study the structure of earth and also all the activities which are happening on the surface of earth or inside the surface of earth. For example, the earthquakes, the eruptions of lava, and the presence of different types of materials in different areas of earth are studied under this branch. If you become a master of this branch, you will become a geologist. Next category is chemistry. Chemistry is the knowledge of elements and compounds and a lot more. The details will be given by your chemistry teacher. The next category is astronomy. Astronomy is basically study of all the heavenly objects. What are the heavenly objects? Heavenly objects are all the objects which are present inside the sky, like the sun, the stars, all the planet system which you have read in your previous classes. They are all known as heavenly objects. These heavenly objects initially were a source of inspiration for the human being. That big sun which is giving us the heat, the moon, each and everything inspired, and this is one of most interesting field of physical sciences. The next category is meteorology. In this branch of physical sciences, they study the atmosphere, the atmospheric phenomena, and the atmospheric effects on weather. The information about weather helps for the cultivation of crops and for different to prepare us for the expected weather conditions beforehand. This helps the human race in many different ways. Category of physical sciences is our main subject, that is physics. Bachcho, physics is the study of matter, energy, and their mutual relationship. If you want to know how the things are moving, physics will give you the answer. If you want to know how the jets are flying in the air, how the cars are moving on the road, how the trucks are taking the turn, then physics will give you the answer. If you want to know how the robots are working, how the light is working, how this electricity setup is made, and how the sound travels from one place to another, the answer you will find in this branch of physical sciences, that is physics. If you are curious about how your fridge and your air conditioner works, physics will give you the answer. If you want to know how the birds are flying, the answer will be there in physics. Also, how the ships are floating on the surface of water, why they are not drowning inside, why the submarine has the ability to go inside the water and come out, physics will give you the answer. Bachcho, examples are numerous, the answers are numerous, but the time of this lecture is very short. So I'll confine the examples till this last category of physical sciences is our main subject, that is physics. Bachcho, physics is the study of matter, energy and their mutual relationship. If you want to know how the things are moving, physics will give you the answer. If you want to know how the jets are flying in the air, how the cars are moving on the road, how the trucks are taking the turn, then physics will give you the answer. If you want to know how the robots are working, how the light is working, how this electricity setup is made, and how the sound travels from one place to another, the answer you will find in this branch of physical sciences, that is physics. If you are curious about how your fridge and your air conditioner works, physics will give you the answer. If you want to know how the birds are flying, the answer will be there in physics. Also, how the ships are floating on the surface of water, why they are not drowning inside, why the submarine has the ability to go inside the water and come out, physics will give you the answer. Bachcho, examples are numerous, the answers are numerous, but the time of this lecture is very short. So I'll confine the examples till this. The word matter in the definition of physics is familiar to you. This word refers to the three different states, which are known as solid, liquid, and gas. On the other hand, the word energy is also used in everyday life. Like you must have said this to your parents, "I feel so energetic today." And when you feel energetic, you play a lot, you do a lot of work, and you behave actively. On the other hand, sometimes of the days, you also say that "I feel so low, I don't have any energy to do anything." So energy can be said as the ability to do work. Significant change in the behavior of matter can be observed when it is having energy. Just like you feel more energetic, you do a lot of work, you feel less energetic, you do less work. So let's check it out. For example, let's consider this cricket ball. If the batsman hits it with less energy, it will end up in the hands of the fielder. On the other hand, if the batsman hits the ball with more energy, the ball will go outside the field and add 6 runs to the score of the batsman. So, water is a liquid and it also shows different behavior with different amount of energy. Right now in this river, the water is flowing smoothly, and this river water can be used to do a lot of useful tasks like transporting the goods and the passengers from one place to another. But if the same water is falling from the tap, it is having less energy, even then it is useful. But the same water, when it comes in the form of flood, causes a lot of destruction. Now here is the gas, that is air, with a lot of energy, and here's the air, same air with less amount of energy. In one case it is a storm, and in the other case it is a hurricane. So gas and energy together, they also create different sorts of behavior.